Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to do the Pen & Games Project Pen update number 2. Insane, it's already 2 months in, but this is a collab with the Pentastic Ladies on Facebook. If you're not already a member of that group and you love penning and everything with that kind of stuff, please check out the link in my description box and it will send you right over to the group. This project is created by Amber and she will be linked down in the description box as well as all the other participants in this Project Pen. This project is based on Hunger Games and in the intro we had a big box or basket or something with 50 items in it, skincare or makeup, whatever you wanted to pen basically. In 30 seconds we were supposed to pick 24 items out of that box and we were not supposed to look. It was intense. So if you want to see that process, that thing, please check out my intro. I am going to show you my products and empties and all that jazz and I'm so excited to share. So let's start off with my empties. I have 2 items that I have finished and 1 that I am going to declutter, and I have already talked about this in my empties. It's not up yet, I believe, when this goes up, but it will soon. The first item that I'm going to declutter and call done is my Nuxe lip balm. This is dead, so appropriate, right? But yeah, it is all the way down to here. I have finished like half of it and I'm very excited about that. It has turned on me. My lips don't like it and it has created bumps in the texture of the lip balm and it's not supposed to be like that. So this is done. This is out and I'm so sad that I'm going to throw it in the trash. Or maybe I should scrape it out and clean this tub and reuse it because it is a pretty nice jar. Maybe I should do that. For the empties, the first one is a body lotion in, and if you saw my first update, so the last update, you would not be surprised. But this is the Juuldale Moisturizing Wonder Lotion in number 5. And can you see my markings? I was up there in the intro and last update I was all the way down to here, so in 1 or 2 uses this was gone. I did love that it came with a pump. I like the lotion itself, but it's just a lotion to me. It didn't do amazing things. My makeup empty for the month is the Rimmel London Match Perfection Foundation. It is light to medium coverage and when I used it in the last few months, it was not the coverage I would have liked because I had a lot of acne going on and it didn't cover that correctly, but so I used a little bit more. So I scraped it all out with my beauty spatula that I got off eBay, by the way. And in the intro I was up to there and then last update I was there and then I finished all of that in a month or maybe 3 weeks. 3 weeks, because I have used the other foundation in this project for like a week or 2 weeks. That was my empties, so now let's move on to the rest of the items. And I am going by, oh my god, that's not the 2 seconds. The wrong product. So the first item that I actually haven't used is the Melissa exfoliator. I said last time that I would use it. Maybe I have used it once or twice, but I can't see any progress on it. I do like this stuff a lot and I'm down to there. Just haven't been in my routine. Then I have this day cream. It is from Matas Natur and it is with E vitamin and aloe vera, I believe. Last update I was up to there and now I'm up to there. So it is a pump that goes up and yeah, it is this kind of format. So I didn't mark it in the intro, but I am assuming that I made just as much progress in the intro to first update. An item that I'm really excited about because I didn't know how to put it in my routine and make it work. This is the W7 Glow It All Multi-Glow Serum. This one, I love using this in the morning. So after I have cleansed my face with a cleansing water, I apply this and let that sink in, and then I apply my day cream on top. It has this beautiful shine through my day cream and give something to my skin when I apply makeup. So in the intro and first update, I was at the top line and now I'm down to there. So I'm pretty excited about that progress. And this has a beautiful shine. It is like a blue duochrome, so it's beautiful. The hair serum I have is from Yves Rocher and it is a beautiful serum. I really, really enjoy using this in my hair. I use it every time I have been in the shower, like afterwards, you know, in damp hair. And this is my intro first update and now I am down to there. So I am making steady progress, maybe a little bit more this time around, but I am really enjoying using this and I have created a habit to use that one. An amazing progress is on my Tony and Guy Seesaw texturizing spray. I use it every time I have my curls in my hair and I have been enjoying this. This is the smaller size, so it goes faster than the full size. I assumed I was there in the beginning first update because I maybe used it once, and now I am all the way down to here. I use this method where it is the heaviest, I mark it. So yeah, down to there. Now to the makeup part, that is the most exciting for me at least. It is the W7, it's a matte made in heaven, heavenly matte foundation. And this is the foundation that I am using at the moment. It doesn't go that fast. You can see here my progress. Intro first update and now second update. I have used it for like a few weeks and this will take me so much longer than the Rimmel London one because this can look so cakey if you put a lot on at once. So I use like one entire pump, maybe two pumps for my whole face and neck. So it goes a little bit slower, but I don't mind. It is a beautiful foundation. I have it on right now. I just think my skin looks really, really great. And I especially love it on camera. In real life, it can look a little bit dull or on the way to cakey if I don't set it and my skin isn't even, you know. Then I have my primer. This is from Max Factor. It is the Facefinity All Day Primer and it is supposed to extend the wear of foundation and it is with SPF 20. I am loving this primer at the moment and as you can see it is very empty because this is my 1 month progress. I didn't use it the first month because I was focusing on another primer that I finished and I am really enjoying it. It is one of my only primers at the moment, so I don't mind. It is really, really beautiful on the skin and so nice. A product I'm not really sure if I can mark it or not where I think it is. It is my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in 15. So it is one of the lightest shades, I believe. So I was there in the intro and first update. And it is kind of settling down here. Can you see that right there? Excuse my nails. I need to do them tonight. But I think I'm down to there. I'm not really sure. But I have used it every single time I wear makeup. I need to use this and get it into my makeup routine basically because it is the W7 Glow Guru Illuminating Face Cream in Pink Glow. This is the palest shade and it is the shade that is going to match me here the end of fall, winter and then beginning of spring before we get all the sun again. This is going to match me well and is going to look very nice underneath the foundation. I don't know how it is going to be with the matte foundation and this one. I don't think the serum is shining through as much, so maybe this is going to be nice. I have no idea, but I need to use it soon. I am still at that mark there, so I have a lot to go through because there is 1.23 fluid ounces in this, so it is a big one. Another W7 product is my W7 Set It Up Special FX finishing powder. I'm trying not to tilt it because there's a lot of product in the lid and I'm really trying to use that up before I can pour more out. But yeah, that is my line. I believe I'm still at that line because I haven't poured anything out of the container. And maybe I can show you how much I have in it and take a screenshot for next time. This is all in the lid that I have left. It was totally covered last update. And yeah, and since last update, I have finished my powder that I'm working on. So now this is the only powder I use on my face. I use a different powder underneath my eyes to set my concealer because that just work for me, you know? So I don't want to use any other powder for my concealer. Then we have my W7 Strobe & Go Strobing Stick. This one right here, it is a highlighter and it is in the shade Moonlight. It is the beautiful champagne-y color and it is beautiful. Let me swatch it. I have it underneath a powder highlight today and it is so bright. I love it so much. This is so beautiful and I have even put it on top of powdered skin today and it wasn't patchy, so this is amazing. I'm using this under and on top of powder products. This is my progress right there in the middle. Not a lot, but it is a highlighting stick and I'm using my finger and then applying, and you don't need a lot and I'm not bare on my shoulders or anything, so I'm not using it on my body anymore as I would have in the summer. Maybe this summer I can use it more. It's so far away at the moment. But yeah, 17 minutes, oh my goodness. My Essence eye primer I haven't used, so I'm not going to talk about that. I am so looking forward to using that though, but not right now. Then I have my L'Oreal Infallible eyeshadow in Magnetic Coral, and I really hope you guys can see the progress because I have used it so much this month. So this is where I am. I hope you can see how much I have used it and where I have dipped my brush in. I'm not going to use it up anytime soon, but hopefully I can use it up by the finale. That would be awesome. My eyebrow pencil from W7, it is the Twist and Shape, this one right here. It has a spoolie on this end and then the pencil on this end. It is a thicker one and this is all I have left right now. It is this one right here and I have made a ton more progress this month because I am using this only. And yeah, I'm loving it. I have it in my brows right now with a darker eyebrow gel, but it is the base color of my brows. It is so blue. Green maybe? I don't know. Let's stay with the paper and talk about my eBay lip liner in number 4. It is a beautiful nude color. This one right here. Yeah, I love this one. Look at that. I'm so excited about this progress. I have used it so much and I have used it all the time with the lip product I have in this project that I have used so much. Most of September actually. It is the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in Cannes. I love this color so much. It is a perfect color match for me. The last item I have is my Niel Jour mascara. It is the extension mascara. I use it every single day and I was almost going to throw it out in my latest M-test that I just filmed. I am keeping it for one more month, I think. I have used it for 2 months now. It is dry. It's not my favorite. I don't really like it. I'm pairing it with another mascara at the moment and it is the mascara that I am wearing today. I actually quite like the finish, so I will keep this in for a few months, maybe only one. I have not decided yet, but the other mascara that I'm using with this is not beautiful on its own, so I don't really know. So that is everything for my update. I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you want to see more of me and my videos and don't want to miss out on anything, please subscribe down below and click the bell. And then until my next video, please take care. Bye.